we were asked, I guess it was in late 2007, if we would like to become heroes. And we said, well, what do you mean by that, Red Cross? And they said, well, maybe you could raise X amount of money. At that time, we were, and still are, on the disaster action team for the tri-counties of Washera, Green Lake, and Marquette. And so we already saw the work of the Red Cross intimately as we would respond to fires. And so we said, yeah, you know, why don't we, well, we're professional musicians. Why don't we take the gift that we have and let's have a little concert in our home. And I think we had maybe 60 people at that concert. We served a few refreshments and I made some desserts. We had about 7 or 8 silent auction items. And at the end of the day, we could boast that with our friends' help, we had raised $3,308.36. We were pretty excited. And so now I'm going to hopefully move the laptop successfully so you can hear my handsome husband share his artistry. Forward. Can you see it?
Perfect, Vicki.
There you go.
Okay, thanks, Jocelyn.
So we'll give you another one here. I'm sure you all know this one. Feel free to clap and sing along because we can't hear you anyway. Here's one called Just Because. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Thank you very much. I'm going to switch gears here and give you a waltz if I can find the other half of it. I lost it. Oh, there it is. this is one called Waltz Across Texas. That last one was Wayne King's theme song, The Waltz You Say For Me. We're going to switch gears here a little bit and give you, I guess, a little swing tune next. Let me get everything in here that I need to have. We're ready to go. This one is one called It Had to Be You. Thank you.
just to be sad, thinking of you. Some others I've seen might ever be mean, might ever be cross, or might be boss, but they wouldn't be. It had to be you, wonderful you, it had to be you.
Accordion. I've had it for, oh man, probably 17 years now, something like that.
Right.
I got it used from a gentleman. It was made in Italy. It has three sets of reeds in the front here. It weighs 35 pounds, and that's how I actually got it used, because the gentleman that used to play it had a heart attack, and he could no longer lift that amount of accordion while he was playing and everything. So he got one with just electronics. Now this one has both. It has the regular accordion, as you hear, of course, with the reeds coming through. But to my right here, there are three sound modules that I get different sounds from as well. And on the last one there, to give you an idea, and I program it like the computer. So this happens to be number 63, and that's my guitar sound on the right hand. Oh, sorry, if I do it the right way, here's 63. Give you an idea, and then you can add layers on there so you get the full sound if you'd like. And you can do all of that, of course, without even moving the bellows. And then the bass side, there's 120 buttons over here, if you can see all of those or not. And I can't see them at all when I play. There's one cheek button on that whole 120, and that is middle C, is got a little indentation on it. But otherwise, you just learn as you practice to kind of guess what they are, and you go from there. So it's rather intriguing. I have to play everything. The only thing that is recorded is the drum sounds that you hear. That comes out of this machine in the front here. And there are A through G plus 1 through 16 different choices. So you multiply all those, and you have lots of different rhythms you can get. There's a pedal in front of me. You probably can't see that, but to start that, I just start with my foot. And then if I want to add some fills like I did before, I just press one of those. And it will keep doing that as long as I keep playing it. So I told Vicki and she and I, as drummers, are out of luck. I can do everything with just my feet here, one foot actually. I'm going to play two more selections for you. Oh, and I should give credit to Bill Chambers, a lot of the things that you hear here today. I started playing with Bill when we were back in Madison, and there was a trio of us. We played every Friday, Saturday night, and then every other Sunday afternoon at a country club. So we got a lot of playing, and plus working our regular jobs. We were all younger then at that point, obviously, because we would play for 4 hours and think nothing of it at night. And so Bill was great in that. And then Jerry was our accordion player. I was actually the drummer for the group. And Jerry had an accordion similar to this. So when I started this 17 years ago, he was very helpful in getting me organized and telling me what gear I needed to have. So we're going to take you back just a few years right now for this next tune. And I'm sure you know this one too. I think in playing out in the assisted livings and everything I could do, Wisconsin, of course, is known for the Packers. We're known for cheese, and we're known for beer. And I think sometimes I think I could play a whole set of about 45 minutes at least of either beer tunes or something like that. So I thought today I would give you one called In Heaven There Is No Beer. Thank you, everybody. It was fun playing for all of you today. And I was wondering if she was going to come up with a beer or not, because she did do that yesterday, so.
Only I found an extra one today.
Yeah, yes, true.
I just managed to.
Two-fisted today.
Indeed.
Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, honey. That was awesome. I'm going to switch, and Jocelyn, you tell us how we're doing here with being able to see myself now. How are we doing?
Well, I think you turned the camera off.
Whoops.
Or maybe unplugged.
Really?
What happened?
Yeah.
Got unplugged the camera. Let's just check.
Yeah, you're muted.
Oh, sorry, everybody. Here we go. Is that better?
There you are.
Wow, okay. And I'll be hanging out here at the piano.
Let's have you tilt it down a little bit for me, John.
Okay.
Thank you, Jocelyn.
Perfect.
Awesome. Well, I want to tell you why my passion for the Red Cross. So, in the fifth grade, several years ago, we were in history class. I remember it almost like it was yesterday. I can see where we were. I grew up in North Dakota, an hour from the Canadian border, in a tiny town of maybe 50 people, okay? And we were in Mrs. Motti's history class. Now, growing up in the 50s and 60s, like I did, there weren't many female role models spoken of in our history books. Well, we heard of Betsy Ross and the flag. We heard of Florence Nightingale, a wonderful nurse. We heard of Pocahontas, who led Lewis and Clark, actually through my home state, through North Dakota. And then she talked about Clara Barton. And I was absolutely smitten with this little pint-sized woman, a teacher, and I wanted to be a teacher, and that she had, during the Civil War, tended to hundreds of fallen soldiers, many of whom were actually her own students. And I thought, on that very day, someday I want to become involved in the Red Cross. And so that someday was not for many, many years later. In 2007, right back here in our dining room, Craig Starkweather, who was our Red Cross leader, came to the house, and I said, well, I'm really interested in deploying nationally, but I sort of can't because I have this job in Madison. I'm a conductor with the Wisconsin Youth Symphony Orchestras. And he said, well, Vicki, you're probably not going to be deploying right away. More than likely, what you're going to be doing is attending to local disasters. And I thought, what local disasters? The occasional strong wind comes through or tornado. We live on sand, so we're not even bothered with floods, but I'm sure there would be floods, perhaps, in the riverbeds, of course. And he said, oh, no, it's residential fires. And you will go out on the fires and you will collaborate with team members. You'll work with law enforcement. You'll work with EMTs. You might be in charge of canteening, feeding and watering the firefighters. And I thought to myself, oh, no, I didn't know it was that horrific. I mean, I'm a professional musician. My purpose in life, largely, is to play, hopefully, beautiful music that sort of soothes the human soul, including mine. Right? So I slept on it overnight. And that next day I signed on to be a member of the disaster action team. And I would write a song dedicated to Clara Barton. And John and I are going to read the script, and then I will play the composition. So here we go. Clarissa Harlow Barton, Clara, as she wished to be called, is one of the most honored women in American history for being a true pioneer as well as an outstanding humanitarian. As pioneer, she began teaching school at a time when most teachers were men. She was among the first women to gain employment in the federal government. As a pioneer and humanitarian, she risked her life when she was nearly 40 years old to bring supplies and support to soldiers in the field during the Civil War. Then, at age 60, she founded the American Red Cross in 1881 and led it for the next 23 years. Her intense devotion to the aim of serving others resulted in enough achievements to fill several ordinary lifetimes.
Clara Barton was working as a recording clerk in the U.S. Patent Office in Washington, D.C., when the first units of federal troops poured into the city in 1861. The war had just begun. The troops were newly recorded, and residents in the Capitol were alarmed and confused. Barton perceived an immediate need for all this chaos, for providing personal assistance to the men in uniform, some of whom were already wounded, many hungry, and some without bedding or any clothing except what they had on their backs. Like a few other women, Barton provided clothing and assorted goods and supplies to the sick and wounded soldiers. Besides supplies, she offered personal support to the men in the hopes of keeping their spirits up. She read to them, wrote letters for them, listened to their personal problems, and prayed with them. She knew, however, that where she was needed most was not behind the lines in Washington, but on the battlefields where the suffering was greatest. Barton prodded leaders in the government and the army until she was given passes to bring her voluntary services and medical supplies to the scenes of battle and field hospitals. Following the Battle of Cedar Mountain in Northern Virginia in August 1862, she appeared at a battlefield at midnight with a wagon load of supplies drawn by a four-mule team. The surgeon on duty, overwhelmed by the human disaster surrounding him, later wrote, I thought that night, if heaven ever sent an angel, she must be one. Her assistance was so timely. Thereafter, she was known as the Angel of the Battlefield.
Clara was never satisfied with remaining with the medical units at the rear of the column. At Antietam, she ordered the drivers of her supply wagons to follow the cannon and traveled all night, actually pulling ahead of the military medical units. While the battle raged, she and her associates dashed about, bringing relief and hope to the field. Imagine now, if you can, a beautiful sun-streaked dawn in rural Virginia with the Blue Ridge Mountains in the distance, the birds and animals beginning to awaken, the Confederate and Union soldiers awakening as well. Just a small but verdant pasture separates them, and then another bloody, inevitable battle ensues. We glimpse Clara leading the medics amidst the carnage. Eventually, the battle ceases. The animals and birds resume their chatter, and in homage to the fallen soldiers, a song is heard, Clara's song. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. I know we've run past 1:30, but there are two other things that I'd like to present to you. And so as you need to leave, by all means do, but if you can stay, we'd be grateful for that as well. It's so important to tell you right now, especially given what we're all going through, okay, across the globe, that you are part of the world's greatest humanitarian organization. Does that not lift your spirits? Your genius, and each one of us has our individual talents. I look at the screen and I see Karen Reynolds. I can barely balance my own checkbook. I am so grateful for Karen because she's our financial guru. She's amazing. She doesn't miss anything. But I have talents even that Karen does not have. John has talents that I don't have. Every single person matters. You are incredible. It is wonderful to follow in the footsteps of one of the strongest women I have ever read about. Yes, my mother ranks right up there as well. But to be inspired by someone who, even upon her death, couldn't even vote. Imagine that. Imagine that. So take hope, everybody. You're part of something much greater than yourself. And what you have to offer the Red Cross is incredible. It is priceless, which each one of you are capable of. I would like to play because part of our Musicale, so we would, if this had all happened normally, we would have had 200 people here. We would have raised close to $15,000. We're still going to raise the money, but just in a different format. The whole point being is that one of our traditions, as well as that Pledge of Allegiance that begins each show, is to sing two audience sing-alongs. We're just going to do Amazing Grace today, and I will play a couple of verses of it. So if you wish to join along, please do that. It's part of our tradition. And then I will finish with a song called Jubilation, because I think that we must remind ourselves to be jubilant, that there is hope, and that we simply can't give up. But first, Amazing Grace. I could hear your spirit right through this beautiful thing known as a laptop. Thank you, everybody. Beautiful job. And we are going to finish, or I guess I am finishing, with a tune called Jubilation. I wrote this in honor of my parents who have been gone. My father passed in 2011 and served in World War II. And that's one of the reasons that the Heroes Musicales have had two missions over the years. SAF, Service to the Armed Forces, because that it's deep in my heart. I have such respect for our military men and women, what they sacrifice for our country. And then, of course, local disaster relief. And then my mother passed more recently in 2015. So this is jubilation. They lived their life jubilantly, and they taught my sister and myself to live it jubilantly, and the people with whom I associate with, my family and friends, do the same. So I wish the very best for you, John does as well, that we stay healthy during this time, that we are smart, that we think of the greater good rather than our own selves, and that we do what needs to be done. Thank you again for attending our Heroes Musicale. We really appreciate and we love you. God bless you. This is jubilation.
Thank you, everybody.
Yes. God bless you.
Ooh, my dog wanted to say good job. Oh.
Because he saw the cat, maybe. Oh, wonderful. Well, thank you, everybody. This has been such a joy. Becky, thank you for giving us this idea. We just assumed that we had to cancel. Well, we wouldn't be doing them. But I do want to tell you before you leave, next year's date is automatically is set for Saturday, April 24th. All of the musicians have said yes. The entire Heroes team, which is a lot of people, have said yes. So we sure want you in our home. And it'll be a different world, hopefully even a better world than we live in right now. So thanks, everybody. Thanks, Jocelyn.
Thanks, guys.
All right. Bye, everybody.
Bye.
God bless.